thought that was sweet. And I started to go, and he said, hey, what you doing tomorrow? Because I'll be here at the corner of Bleecker and Mercer tomorrow at 7. If you wanna meet up, I'll be waiting right here. And in case there are two fellas waiting for you, my name's John. He waved and then he was gone. Needless to say, I went back there to meet him, mostly to see if he'd show. And there he was, out in the cold, with his jacket pulled tight. He took me to dinner and kissed me goodnight. The next week we went to this terrible play, and the week after that drank hot chocolate all day. When suddenly, 8 or 9 months had flown by, and he said, hey, what you doing the rest of your life? I'll be here, right beside you, as long as you want me to be. There's no question. There is nothing I've wanted so much in my life. This might sound immature, but I'm totally sure you're the one. And we had just begun. We got hitched in September, our favorite month, with a DJ he met at his old. And we bought an apartment on West 17th Street and talked about children and getting a dog. Our first anniversary came in a flash, and we promised to take the day off. He had to stop into his office that morning, so I went walking uptown to this bakery I know. When I heard on the street what I thought was a joke, I noticed the sirens and saw the smoke. So I'm running back home with this feeling of dread to the voicemail he left. And the last words he said, I'm sorry, I don't mean to ruin your evening by bringing up all of this stuff. You're probably wondering why I even called you tonight. Today something happened that spooked me all right. I saw this storm cloud of papers fall down from the sky, and I thought of that day, and I started to cry. When sure as I breathe, I heard John clear as day, same thing, you're allowed to move on. It's okay, because I'll be here. Decide to get rid of my favorite sweater. Even if you go out on my birthday this year, instead of sitting at home letting all of